people in Southeast Alaska, they don't live by the clock. They live by the seasons. And the seasons are defined by delicious things like salmon, berries, and deer. And I quickly found myself falling into that way of life and loving that way of life. You fall into this rhythm of life there. And it's as natural as the tides ebbing and flowing every day, and the wind blowing through the trees and the salmon coming up the creeks. You quickly realize that you're a part of that ecosystem. Cruising up Chatham Strait, I jerk my head in all directions as hundreds of salmon erupt from the sea like popcorn bursting into the air. It's salmon time in the Tongass, a time when bears get fat and fishermen don't sleep, a time when eagles shriek and creeks sing, a time to indulge my taste buds. In Sitka, I ask a local where to go for the best salmon in town. He advises me to meet someone fast and get invited over for dinner. Luckily, this isn't difficult. People are generous with the bounty in this fruitful part of the world. In Craig, a charter boat captain treats me to grilled coho brushed with pineapple glaze. At a native gathering in Cake, my entire being purrs upon savoring king salmon still warm from the smokehouse. In Heidelberg, a family serves me smoked sockeye, pickled wild beach asparagus, and Yukon gold potatoes. Kings and queens never had it this good. I start an informal poll and I ask everyone I meet if eating salmon ever gets old. Everything in moderation, right? Wrong. Not a single person hesitates before answering with a definitive no. For me, wild salmon is always a treat. For the people in Southeast Alaska, it's a way of life. Summers are spent catching, cleaning, smoking, freezing, and canning for personal use. The commercial salmon industry is a mainstay of the local economy, and it's been certified as sustainable by the Marine Stewardship Council. Catch numbers, area openings and closures, and fish politics are headline news. I like this way of life, spending time harvesting, preparing, and sharing delicious and nutritious wild food. It feels right. It builds community. It builds entire cultures, just ask the native folks. To the wild salmon of the Tongass, I bow my head in respect and thanks.